Hey, this is Dr. Amanda with StraightSmile Solutions, StraightSmileSolutions.com, and today I wanted to talk to you a little bit about power tube or power thread. And they are two different things, but they look very similar and they function in similar ways. So you can see here, So see how I'm stretching it? Oops, do you see how it rebounded? This is actually like a very thin piece of elastic. That's right here, okay? It's like a thread, but it's an elastic-y thread, okay? So you can, I'm like flicking it. Can you see what I'm doing? So anytime you want to tie it to something, you can tie it to an eyelet, you can tie it to a gold chain and an exposure. You just need to thread it through, and you just need to tie it tight. Usually I do two knots, one, and then the next. So I'm going to show you here how I would tie it, okay? I mean, it's just a regular, you know, square knot, basically, is what you're doing. You know, go back to your Girl Scout, Boy Scout handbook and do a square knot. Boating, whatever you like to do. Okay, so one, real tight, okay, and then the next one. You have to tie it real tight or it just unravels because it is a thread. Now there's tube and thread, and usually it comes in a variety of different diameters, okay? So there's usually 025 and 030, depends on what you're gonna do with it. If you're gonna go into an eyelet, you might wanna get 025. If you're gonna go into a gold chain, or something else, you might want to get 030. I personally prefer the tube to the thread. I find that it stays tight better. This is actually the thread and not the tube. But so the way you can tell the difference is when you look straight down, if it's tube, it'll be hollow. You can press it, and this is thread. But regardless, it all works, right? Over time, these things get really, really, really brittle. So I would say you maybe have a year-long lifespan on it, and then you want to throw it out and get new ones. After you tie it to the patient, you need to trim, obviously, the extra flash off of it, the extra. Make sure you're always leaving a little tail like that, because if you don't, it completely unravels. So I'll kind of show you here. Sorry, I'm trying to cut this while looking through the lens of the video. Okay, that's probably a little too much slack, but you kind of get the idea. You want to leave a little bit of a slack. It doesn't hurt or anything. I mean, it's just soft rubber. So you let the patient know that they're going to feel a little tail there. You can probably go a little bit more close. But yeah, that's pretty much it. It's a really easy way to engage things, especially if you can't yet run them into a bracket. And theoretically, you can also use it in aligners. It's a very useful product. I would definitely get it. All right. Hopefully that helps. Thanks so much. Don't hesitate to reach out with any other questions.